Sorry, I learned to drink. You know, I drink water and tea, and y'all know I drink wine, but I also drink water and tea, and I'm trying to cut back on my wine like y'all told me to, okay?
What's in that cup? That's
Crystal.
still you. What's in that
Hey.
cup?
Crystal.
Tea.
Crystal.
Tea.
Crystal.
I answered this question.
Crystal.
What y'all want from me, man? I mean, dang.
We want better from you.
Wait a minute. I thought you
It's
said you were submissive, Crystal.
my
That don't
beautiful
sound
sister.
submissive. No.
Yeah,
Okay.
the
I'm
true spirit is coming out.
sorry.
She caught herself a couple times already. And we got it
I'm
on
not a
camera.
feminist. Stop calling me a feminist. I'm not. I am not a feminist. I just don't know why.
Who just called you a feminist?
Woman,
You
you are a
said
beautiful
the
woman.
feminist is coming out. You said I
That's not
heard
what
you.
I said. That's not
Treat
what I said.
yourself how
I
others
said the
want to.
true spirit.
Okay, listen to me.
There she
I
go. There's that Negro
with
woman.
your
There she
bright
go.
red lipstick.
There she go. There's that Negro woman. There she go.
I am not a Negro woman. Don't say that.
Yeah, the curtains are closed. The
I'm
costume comes off.
a
There
very
she go.
submissive woman. Stop saying that,
There
Tyler
she
Doc.
go.
Okay.
Ooh, now you're telling the man what to do.
Hey,
Whoa.
Kajal,
I did not tell him when I'd ever tell him what to do. I did not
you
tell
just
him.
said stop saying that.
Stop saying that.
You just saying that. You're trying to deprive me of a First Amendment right or a right reserved by the First Amendment, freedom of speech.
Can I just say something?
That's what feminists do. You can't say that. Hey, yeah, stop saying that. I feel threatened.
I love all y'all. I do. I love you. I love the men of Israel. I love the black man. And I'm, you know what? Okay. We all fall short, but I love the
We
black
go.
man.
There she go. There she go. The Negro woman is coming out now,
We
boy.
love you
I'm not
too.
Negro woman.
We
I'm
love you.
not.
We love you too.
Oh, wait, can I say something? So you mean to tell me? See, I've been by, I'm learning a lot from this. Oh, us ladies could be something else. 'Cause Crystal, I really thought you was one of them, Crystal. That real Crystal came out there. Ah,
Yeah.
hold on. I'm just joking. I'm just joking. But no, but I am starting to learn a lot because then that would mean that what Kahan has been saying a lot. I've been listening. What he said in the beginning, women get like that. See, a lot of times women don't listen. I've been listening now because the pride is gone, the ego, the flesh is shed. So while I'm listening, I realize that means that a women do, now I'm not saying you, Chris. I'm just brought me back to this. Women can be tricky and they can deceive a man. And in the beginning, it's all this and that. And then
Yeah.
once they get in, it's like all of a sudden, you know. So I heard you. I heard all of you brothers and sisters, but we can't be biased. You know, sometimes I lean, well, back then I used to lean a lot. I used to be very persuaded by I speak to a lot of women, because of course. I'm not supposed to be speaking to a lot of men. You know what I'm saying? Because when you do that, I found myself trying to help men with the word. They try to do something else. I'm like, okay, no. And that's why Elohim said, this is why I said to do stuff in an order for you guys' protection. Everything's in order. But I just think that this is beautiful. We're getting somewhere though. What just happened with Yehoshua being? I will really be praying on this, y'all, in the mighty name of Yehoshua, Father. I want to pray right now, but I'm not going to take it there. Maybe we can close out in prayer tonight. If we
You
can
know
maybe
what?
close out in prayer, that would be beautiful.
You
Can we
know
do
what?
that and pray together?
All he did was ask me one simple question: what's in the cup? All I had to do was say what's in the cup. I didn't have to go through all that. So you know what?
Yes,
Y'all
but
right.
look,
Was
don't put the
good.
costume back on now, Crystal. Don't put the costume back on now.
I don't have no
We
costume.
already look backstage. We already look backstage. That Nephilim that just came out,
I'm
yeah,
not Nephilim. Nephilim.
I got a precept real quick. I got a precept real quick, and just to reiterate, so just as long as we're clear, wine in Yahusha's day was 100% cold press grape juice.
Know, in the world, they just go ahead and we've learned that. That's why, you know. I looked at it like I've honestly been in polygamous relationships. Think about behind my back. Think I just didn't know. So, but
It's like if you do
I
both,
did. I come to think about it. No,
because it's
I have
nice.
experience. You know, I would say I have experience a little bit because I remember getting kind of cool with one of the girls that, you know, he cheated. Well, you know, stepped out on without me ever knowing. for months, and we got cool, and actually we're cool to this day. It's not a sister, you know, but that's what I'm saying. I've seen situations work where it's like you got to put just jealousy aside, because I don't have any issues with anyone. Even when I was in my 10-year relationship, there was this girl who hated me, and she slept with my ex. You know, I'm like, I don't understand how you mad at me, and you calling me to show me that you were messing with him. You trying to find my number so bad and my Facebook and stuff just to show me that. So it's, a lot of women do things to be malicious and stuff, and I think that if it was a situation like this, I wouldn't want to do it to, it wouldn't be for the flesh. It wouldn't be like, I want to do this to get
back. I have a question, and I can't believe these guys are not saying anything, so I'm just going to be the Israelite to say it. Always got to be the bad guy.
Oh, boy.
No, I'm just keeping it all the way real, man. These guys are not saying anything. So, Alicia, Moshe, and Crystal, right? So it seems like all three of you have this, like, mindset that, you know, the man's going to, he's going to be the provider of everything. So I got to ask, what exactly are you going to provide him with? What are you bringing to this equation that's valid? Because if he's a wise man, he's going to ask that. What are you bringing that's going to bring value to his life? Because a relationship is supposed to be give, take, not give, give, give. So true, what exactly true. Are you guys bringing a value to that man if you get involved in that kind of relationship?
That's a good question. I seen Alicia, you unmuted. You wanted to go first? I'll let you go first.
I'll take it. So before putting myself in that position, or I guess the Most High will let me know, hey, this is for you, or here's your place. But until then, I'm putting myself in a position to have income to support and maintain my future needs of these kiddos. So now with that, that brings, I own a little bit of property, and I'm making it to where they're producing, and also the building of the company to hold them, the structure of behind it. And I know that my mind is a huge asset along with my attitude. It's one of those things that it's that in a rating scale, you know, nobody can ever really account for and what it really weighs. One actual attraction, whether you have typical beauty or below average beauty or whatever, but certain people just have a je ne sais quoi, something that you can't necessarily pinpoint. And so it comes with perspective, a certain level of confidence and wisdom to be quiet. So, and follow directions and stay on task and just don't be idle, because being idle will take you bad places and diminishes your productivity, which now, if you're in a unit, it's very, very valuable, and you're not just wasting your time, you're wasting the family's time, because it's not just yours anymore. So I think that mindset could be very well my biggest asset to bring, with submission and along with my studies, my brain, because I think okay, I am.
And your studies and your brain. So let's stop right here. First of all, he's not interested in that, because remember, you guys said a man that is going to provide for you. So that means this man is already established. He doesn't need, listen, he's going to function with or without you. Keep in mind, this man was already established before you came into his life. See, women have this false analogy that, hey, well, I'm going to come into your life and make you better off financially. But he was doing, keep in mind that this man was making it before you came in. And so the dangers in that, a lot of women will come in and say, well, yeah, I made you more valuable by, so the a man that's on his purpose is not really going to be too interested in your financial. Now, if you're if you want to work and provide something, then obviously, then yeah, you're supposed to share that with the household. But when you say your mindset, I guess you're going to have to develop a little more, because this man, you've already placed the burden on him of providing everything. So I'm asking you, because he doesn't need your mindset, remember? Because he's already established. He already got that in check. So he's already making it. He's already able to provide for someone else to come into the relationship. So again, what are you going to give him that's a value to him? Because what are you saying? You're going to enhance his mind when you're saying you're bringing your mindset? Elaborate on that a little.
What I'm saying is that my attitude is that of, okay, whatever it takes to continue on with the path that you want the team to go on. So if that means do this, then okay, I'm going to learn to do it the best that I can. That's what I mean by my mindset and my brain, because, you know, I've kind of already studied a few things where I could pick up and kind of jump on the ball quickly. As far as, hey, what do you need me to be? Do you need me to be the secretary? Do you need me to go out in the field and do this? What do you need me to do? That's kind of, and the attitude to say, well, you know, I'm not going to have the attitude to say, well, I don't like that. Or, you know, I don't want to do this or whatever. It's not about me. It's about us.
So I think the more appropriate word there would have actually been support then.
Okay.
Provided him support. And that's usually something that a man is really looking for. If a man is, you know, established, you know, if he's doing, he'd want support. I believe that. He'd want support. I believe he'd want you to help him, like, grow. You see what I'm saying? I believe he would like want you to help him grow in whatever field of endeavor. And that's a support system right there. And so the other things, why don't I tell you guys what a man would want? Let's see if Kadar and Yashabim agree. I would say if a man's established, he's not looking for your money. See, these women go to college and I don't give a shit about degree. I don't care about that. That just usually means I'm going to have more problems with her, because her mind is suffering from cognitive dissonance in most cases. Because sometimes she'll challenge the guy and think she's smarter than the guy instead of coming in and trying to help out. She got this indoctrination that's going to be harder to overcome. So no, thank you. I'll take the girl from Burger King that's willing to be submissive. So what a man is typically looking for, a woman that will offer him support, like a support system. Another thing I believe a man will be looking for is that a woman that could offer a man love and understanding, not challenges. So what happens when a woman offers a man care, love, and understanding? He's usually more attracted to her. He usually wants to do more for her. But for some reason, women just don't seem to get it. They want to challenge him. So he closes off, and then they blame him. A woman could help him feel love by someone who cares deeply about him. In the initial stage, some women do this, but they seem to lose focus. So she could help him feel loved by someone who deeply cares about him. Men also need women in their lives for emotional stability and balance. You see?
True.